So my name is Michelle Van Scoyk. I work at the University of Illinois at Chicago, and I am part of the amazing Winn Lab here. Our lab is in lung cancer field. Lung cancer is the number one killer of cancer-related deaths. You've got people getting lung cancer through asbestos, radon, secondhand smoking. They didn't smoke themselves, you know. So for us, people who have chronic illnesses, they have a champion in us, you know. And so that's why we do what we do. So I was born in Vietnam. I came over here when I was 2 years old. At the time, we were refugees. I was 6 months at the time. They actually got us on a boat. We went to the Philippines, and in the Philippines, we got sponsored. My mom had family in the United States to help sponsor us, to get us over there. We got to the U.S. when I was 2 years old, and growing up, I was such a bookworm, you know, going to the library. And, you know, I'm not really sure where I got the science bug. I mean, it was natural, I guess you would say. I mean, I guess I couldn't see myself doing anything else. This whole lab, we're on the same mission. And that mission is to find that loophole for lung cancer. If you think about it, what can we do to detect it early? What can we do to stop it from metastasizing? What can we do to give people a chance, you know, to live longer, not to see the end point, you know. So there are a family of ligands that are involved in development. And 10, 15, 20 years ago, they thought that these family of genes were oncogenes. And lo and behold, our little lab, we found that there is this one member, there's, you know, a few other members that are similar that doesn't do what the others do. It's actually tumor suppressive in lung cancer. So what's the best thing to do with it? You know, I mean, lung cancer, really, you don't have that many screenings until it's a little too late. So, I mean, if there's something, if there is a gene out there that we can possibly screen, you know, and then lifestyle, you know, I think that would be a great stepping stone as far as detecting early lung cancer incidences in some of these patients. I'm a scientist because my curiosity probably gets the better of me. You know, there's the body is an amazing thing. There's so many things going on at the same time. So many things that can go wrong, and yet your body is smart enough to correct it. The cancer part of it, the cancer science part of it. These people with chronic illnesses, especially in lung cancer, you know, they need champions. I mean, what better way of helping someone? If not in my lifetime, you know, yeah, it would be great if we can find that cure, find that drug, that miracle drug in my lifetime. But if it doesn't, and I know that maybe I was part of a stepping stone, or I trained somebody to carry on, you know, the science. And it could be that person who walked into the lab, you know, who got interested from this video, you know, to go out and to pick up where we left off, you know. I think that would be amazing. That would make me a very happy person. Thank you.